evening, everyone, and welcome to another blockbuster, action-packed, mind-blowing episode of 420 Grams this Sunday evening. I was just watching before the game started, the Dolomite movie. I wish, like, what we need, I think, for this show to become really the shiz. Is a character like that to host it? I think Pandit is getting there, but unfortunately he's not joining us this evening because he's had a long day at the cricket. Sharda Ogra, good evening. How are you?
Hi, I am well. Why is he not joining? Why is Arjun Pandit not joining? Because the cricket was absolutely rubbish today. That's not an excuse. This is just like slightly more elevating, mood lifting kind of thing. You would have loved it. You should have been here.
I know.
I'm here, bhai. Even I watched the match whole day. Subah 9 baje se leke. Hum hai yahan pura maine football bhi dekha hai. Do match notes leke. So.
Dekho. Pandit ji, agar aap dekh rahe hain na, apne hotel room mein baith ke, agar aap dekh rahe hain, sun rahe hain, to please, thoda, aapke paas link abhi bhi hai. You can always hop in. Yeah. But this gentle reprimand from Sharda, please note, sir. And Vaibhav Raghunandan, you've been watching the games in between your household duties, my friend. You have to unmute your microphone first.
And Vaibhav Raghunandan in a Naga shawl. Please let it be noted.
First India captain is state.
Sorry.
So, I just want to say that you said Arjun has had a long day of cricket. What other kind of day of cricket is there? क्रिकेट तो पूरा दिन ही चलता है कुछ भी हो जाए है ना वो टोटल 90 मिनट बोलेगा
नहीं
नथिंग लाइक नथिंग लाइक अ टेरिबल जोक फ्रॉम वैभव टू गेट थिंग्स गोइंग
ऑफ कोर्स
फेयर इनफ गाइस सो शुड वी आई डोंट नो डिड यू मैनेज टू कैच बोथ द गेम्स टुडे एंड लाइक हैव यू बीन ग्लूड टू द आईएसएल ऑल वीकेंड बेसिकली बिकॉज़ वी हैड थ्री बैक टू बैक ड्रॉज आई थिंक two of which were nil.
I have been only glued today. Unfortunately, yesterday, because the BFC were playing, I couldn't watch. But unfortunately for BFC, I couldn't watch. Because for myself, I was told a very dreadful match. And I was out somewhere and I looked at the score. So, not that it was unusual because they've been playing like this for a while now. But it apparently was very dire and a dull match. Today, I enjoyed it, even though it was today I enjoyed even the nil-nil game. So at the moment I'm at that level of what you're saying, no, Josh ho raha abhi tak, so I can watch even a nil-nil match on Sunday night till 9:30. I'll watch it with great enthusiasm. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I liked all the what they call it, sir, open play. Everyone's going for goals. Pagal cheeze ho rahi hai. 2-2 in the Jamshedpur Orissa match. Good fun. It was good fun. Yeah, wo save bhi ho aaye penalty. So I quite enjoyed both the games today. Yesterday I missed out on the boring one.
Web of jump in, yeah.
Yesterday game, so I'll refrain from speaking about because I think BFC's social media team is doing better than their football team right now. But I will not say anything, or BFC ke log chad jayenge. But aaj ka pehla game.
हमारे साथ हैं यहाँ पे. बट आपने पहले पहला तीर छोड़ दिया है.
हाँ बिल्कुल नहीं, बहुत ही बोरिंग गेम. मतलब उन लोगों का गेम पता नहीं क्या हुआ है. द मोस्ट एनिमेटेड आई थिंक एनी बीएफसी मेंबर वाज एट द एंड ऑफ द गेम व्हेन कार्लोस क्वाद्रात वाज लाइक पॉइंटिंग फिंगर्स एंड जंपिंग.
सॉरी आई एम गोइंग टू इंटरप्ट यू बिकॉज़ दिस लाइक इट्स नॉट वर्किंग आउट. या इट्स जस्ट कंप्लीटली स्क्रैची योर ऑडियो, सो आई थिंक यू माइट हैव टू लूज द प्रीटी शॉल.
All right, guys. Fine.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think the most animated was when the coach, BFC coach, was gesticulating wildly after the game. That was like all the action. Wahi par tha 15-20 seconds. Aur aaj ka pehla game was good fun. Second game again, I was pretty sure that Kerala were gonna concede in the 90th minute. By the way. But it didn't happen.
Yeah. So was I. Nice. I thought something was going to happen. They were quite. They looked like that they were going to Chennai and all over them पूरा फर्स्ट हाफ में लिटिल बिट थोड़ा दे काइंड ऑफ रिकवर्ड आफ्टर अबाउट एन आवर एंड अ बिट और समथिंग बट आफ्टर दैट इट होने वाला है बट दे हेल्ड आउट एल्बिनो गोम्स बॉस व्हिच आई सडनली रिमेंबर्ड
दे आल्सो हैड सम गुड चांसेस केरला देमसेल्व्स आल्सो
या
यू नो लाइक
या
एंड आई डोंट नो लाइक व्हाट इट इज आफ्टर एवरी ड्रिंक्स ब्रेक दे केम आउट एंड प्लेड वेल फॉर लाइक 10 मिनट्स सो
Yeah,
I feel like Kibu Vikona and Kerala team should invest in like better earphones or like nice walkie-talkie system because evidently, ladke sunte hain bahut aur fir bhool jaate hain. They did like after every drinks break, 10 minutes Kerala totally. Then Chennai were again getting back.
According to I'm making like just like my focus is completely on now Weber's microphone. For some people, so the feedback that we're getting on the chat is that it's not we made the shawl the scapegoat for no reason at all. The problem is his beard. So are you gonna like remove that while we're live?
Guys, you're asking for too much, yeah.
Live shaving. Yeah, what? Where is the mic part of this?
Not worth it.
Beard only. Beard, I think.
It's
the beard. I just want to say that earlier this year.
Beard.
I had a bad cycling accident and I had this huge gash on my chin. And when I got stitches, the doctor said ki acha aapko daadi katwani padegi. And I said, rehne do, koi baat nahi stitches. So that's how dedicated I am to this.
Okay. Coming back to the games. Sorry about that. It's just What are we making of any standout players, firstly, or key incidents? Of course, we've had red cards, we've had penalties. So, a bit of action on the refereeing front. Definitely, the refs getting involved in the decision making. I mean, of course, referees are always involved, but sometimes decisions have more of an impact on the result, perhaps. And I think that's what happened in the first game at halftime. They were 2-0 up, and I think with the 11. Men seemed to be in control of the situation, but all that changed.
And Rehnesh had a decent game till then.
Yeah.
No, he didn't have albino type of moments in the albino had one horror in the second match, albino Gomes, yeah. Where he had come off his line, he was at the edge of the box, and then, then what is the guy he pulled off to save?
It was a bit too much. Thoda zyada sweeper keeper moment ho raha tha unke saath. But standout for me in the second game, Kerala versus Chennai. I think there were a couple of like Chante was very good today. I don't know. He had some really good, made some good runs. Yeah. Had a great cutback also, which there was no one to receive that cutback in the first half. And then Nongdama Naurem for Kerala. He's a young kid and he was beating people, he was taking the ball and going for guys and it was fun to watch him a little bit.
So, what did you guys think of Rohit Kumar, who was number 8, I think, in the Kerala team? It wasn't too wild a shot at goal, it was a decent shot at goal.
Yeah, it was fine, yeah.
He had a couple of good sort of interceptions, and there was one he took out this. I mean, the guy was tired. You discovered at the end, as you can see, I'm consulting notes because I was very diligent today. Unlike last time, where I forgot names and whatever. It's an art. तैयार रहना चाहिए. Professional show में जा रहे हैं.
Chada, how many things are you going to make us look bad?
No, I've also got notes, man.
But I've also got notes.
I'm like constantly switching.
You guys remember from the top of your head, yeah?
No.
Top of your head. I don't remember top of my head. Oh, age hai yaar, age mera.
Sorry.
So wait. I'm giving your show full izzat also.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Any aisi baat nahi hai, top of the head, even we've got notes. Well, I've got notes. I've just, unlike, because I'm, as you said, age, I've got digital notes. They're on my computer.
Oh, Esme hai na, Esme karke jo unka defender hai. He challenged that Esme and he took him out. Rohit Kumar. I was observing with my observations. and Deepak Tangri, please give us some comments on Deepak Tangri, Siddhant.
Yeah, I thought I mean, so one of the things we noted also about Chennai after their first game was that they are playing these two Indian boys in the middle of the pitch, which is really exciting and fun to watch for us. Also gives you, because several other teams have, of course, their key, because the center is critical to how your team functions, I guess. So have invested heavily in foreign players in those key positions. And I think also, so Anirudh Thapa and Deepak Thanvi are building a good bit of understanding with each other and getting a lot of game time. They'll only get better and better as they get to play more together, I think. And he's 21, I think. And Thapa is also very young, I think probably around the same age, 20, 21 or thereabouts. It's great to see so many of these young boys.
I like how they have Chante and Tangli and Thapa along that same area, and then they've got these two guys in the front. And at the start of the match, I think Chante and Thapa were doing a lot more to give them much, but they didn't convert what they got. The Jodke do forwards, Sylvester and Rujo Dusra, I've forgotten his name. See, this is the problem. But yeah, it's nice to see all these young players suddenly being called up, and you know, very young guys, 22, 18, whatever. Who's the guy who was there today? But I don't know how young he is. Mubashir. He was from Jamshedpur. He played for Jamshedpur.
So there's a few, even. Nongdamba, Vaibhav was talking about.
Yeah.
Both him and Rahul are, I think, batchmates.
They're the same batch in the junior team. Same batch.
And I think Amarjit KP also turned up again. Amarjit.
Jackson.
Jackson, and in the first match, Amarjit was there.
Yeah, first match.
India ka captain tha, under-17.
He was the under-17 captain, yeah.
He was there as well. So it's good to watch them. It's not like that it's a big impact or whatever, but it's there.
Impact will take time. One is that I think a lot of us have quite a bit of investment in these guys, even though they don't know it. Because we've been watching them from the time they were so young, you know. Many of them were then, when they started got into the training program for leading up to the 2017, that World Cup squad. So they were 13, 14, 15 years old, you know. And obviously, as part of our reporting work, we have also been to some of their homes and
you traveled to one of the under-17 players ke ghar rab gaye the na, captain.
As was much talked about at that time, 8 of the players in that squad were from Manipur. Prior to the World Cup, we had gone there and
that's the truth for any team.
Yeah, I suppose so. It is, yeah, for sure. Any football. Yeah, yeah. I don't know. We don't know how many offhand, I guess, but I'm sure there are stats for this, how many Manipuri players there are in each
squad.
I had gotten
the largest number followed by Mizoram.
It had run in very close 3 years back. It was like very close between Mizoram and Manipur 3 years back, but I haven't checked the stats.
And about 30% is the number I had from the Northeast states. That is an average, which is just
10 in 30, Kerala, 30. I think, players from. Okay. And I mean, like, you look at, so one, I think the interesting part of that whole penalty situation for me was how it came about. And so Reagan is another of the Manipuri contingent. And I think
lovely cross.
Yeah.
And on also, pace, like a lot of
The pace that he showed to get onto that from right back. I mean, that's the kind of stuff that will get a coach excited any day of the week.
And he had played the whole match. It wasn't like he just come on, he was a substitute. He played like the whole time. He was involved in the match. You saw him making a lot of other interceptions and all that the whole time. He was pretty much there. So for him to suddenly also be doing this, to have this kind of energy to make that cross and to and to be so fast and literally playing like he was playing in the first 15-20 minutes of the match, kind of, it was very, very impressive. Usko shayad yellow card bhi mila hai, if I'm not wrong, in this game.
Haan, he picked up a yellow card. Yeah. I think, I guess, were either of you guys surprised that Sahel wasn't in the squad, or is that... we saw him threatening to come on a couple of times while he was warming up on the sidelines, but they chose in the end not to bring him on. Ikuna chose not to. Were you guys surprised by that? Or?
I mean, I think maybe because this whole thing of trying out youngsters will give the coach a little bit of sort of wah-wah. But if he thinks that, listen, they won't last that much time, they won't have that much of an impact, let's get slightly older or more experienced or stronger people on. I don't know what they were.
Yeah, it's the third game in 9 days. Kerala's.
So maybe, and they've got an interesting list of upcoming fixtures. I think they've got Goa. Is it Bangalore? And Goa, Bangalore and East Bengal.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Something like that. Am I getting it right? I hope so. Anyway, but either way, three challenging fixtures. I guess it's a small league though, so most fixtures would be challenging.
Yeah, they play
other than BFC.
Yes. Yeah, you're right.
Other than BFC, you're dissing your home team.
What is this? Yeah, how they're playing? Please explain to me what is this.
Neil Chhetri is left winger forward.
What?
That's very useful. I think Chhetri is playing on the left, right? Like if I'm not mistaken. Right?
That's okay.
That's not unusual for him, no?
Yeah. I mean, you can play Chhetri anywhere, and I think.
Yeah. I think so. But has he been? I didn't see yesterday's game, which you watched. Was he at least involved or visible, or was he there? No, because even in the first match that I saw, you didn't see him. That was a thing.
He wasn't. I mean, when you're watching like a BFC game or an India game, it's just natural that you start.
Yeah, that he should be there in everything.
Yeah, you start also looking for him. And yesterday, he wasn't there in it. Like, I really don't know. I don't
recall having seen him.
Yeah, I mean, doing anything like.
Imagine not recall having seen Sunil Chhetri in a match. It's like even say December, mein, January, where you not be able to say this. Like the last season of ISL, no chance, you know. Even though
no, it's also, an average that's what like I mean I'm all right like with like Sunil not being in a game if you're like playing against a side that is completely dominating the ball and you're unable to get the ball to him near the box. But in this case, like Bangalore are going up, attacking, but they're unable to get Sunil involved. And that's why, like, I want to give him the ball near the box. Yeah, like, that's why he should have the ball. I don't want him to have the ball and, like, in your half, like, picking it up. And I mean, yeah, sure, that's what he does a lot of the time, but that's not what he should be doing. His most effective role is around the box when he can get like a shot, he can conjure up something. I don't know.
We have kind of now seen all the teams a decent amount. East Bengal, I guess, not as much as the others, but most of them. How are things looking? So I guess one question is when BFC came onto the scene. First in the I-League and then as they also transitioned into the ISL. They look to have a very much more more advanced in terms of their coaching and backroom setups. More professional in many ways. Like Weber was making a joke about the social media department, but it was only half a joke because they are quite good.
It's phenomenal. If anyone is like, watch all you BFC guys. Like, I love your social media.
Yeah. So, Kunal Mazgaonkar are...
full marks for Kunal,
Who's...
There
is... Yeah, he's been with the club again from the very beginning, I think. From the pretty much the time the club was established. So, as involved as anyone else in that setup. And it shows, I guess, with the players and all as well. Is it... case that as this league is now in its seventh season, the other franchises or clubs or however you want to describe them have also kind of brought in a lot of these best practices or methods of operation and come up to a similar level where you can't really make out such a difference between any two clubs in this side. I mean, we got our friend Arjun got a lot of flack for a couple of comments, which I think were actually mistaken by the people who were commenting. But he got a lot of flack for suggesting in a cheeky manner that Northeast would ship 10 goals. But the point is that of course, that didn't happen. In fact, okay. The opposite. So there are no small teams as such, and everyone seems to have put together, gotten to some kind of a par. Is that the case? Or Mohan Bagan, 80K, sorry, it's confusing. Just ahead of the pack.
Confusing. You don't even use words like confusing at all.
Vaibhav, you go first on this.
Yes, see, okay. First of all, it's got like itna build up nahi hai is season mein, dhada dhada matches ho rahi hai. You know, so this is like a siege mentality season. You know, you have to just khelo. Every game is almost like a cup tie, which also can be ki acha haan aise hi hota hai waise bhi ISL na. But yeah, all the teams are closer to each other. I still think ATK are not because of their quality of football, but just because they're a smarter team and they have a phenomenal defense right now. Till now, they're looking way better than anyone else. Personally, I do think City Football Group have a good team, which is looking like a pretty team. And I do believe that Bangalore are going to abhi humne bol diya hai, toh wo parso ke game mein they'll score.
Four, is it?
Four.
Theek hai. Koi BFC.
My thing, Siddhant, what you're saying about BFC, I think is true. You said what is a very accurate sort of summary of the last few years, because there was a point in time where somebody said that, you know, the one team that everyone wants to play in, this would have been one team that every player wants to be signed up to is BFC. And I don't know whether that is still the case. As in, will that be? I mean, and I'm not talking about size of the paycheck, but just the professionalism with which the club was run. You know, and this is before, of course, now ATK, Mohan Bagan, and Sri Cement's East Bengal are also in. It's that whole thing. And when they came, I remember their first season of the ISL was just incredible. It was like playing at some other level only. And of course, they reached final and then they lost and whatever. But that everyone's caught up because they think, listen, if it can be done, it can be done. You know, it's not like they have got Messi and Ronaldo to play for them. They just got players that are of the budget and this thing that we can also manage, and they've got the right people. And the fact that they had Roca, Albert Roca at that time was huge, because he did some incredible things for them, you know, for BFC. And watching this, I love watching Chennai and Kerala, because they have these fans and it's like this whole crazy thing. And they have this this Indian kind of that threesome in the middle, which is Changte, Tangri, and this. I just love the idea of that, you know, what happens from them, because you'll always see them all the time. They're not invisible tuk chak playing somewhere in the back and one goalkeeper. It's not like that. So I like watching these teams. I'm sure Mohan Bagan is playing whatever, what is that word that is used in football journalism, you know, they say something pragmatic or whatever kind of football, and then they are
succeeding. Park the bus football.
Pardon?
Park the bus football.
Ha, park the bus.
Pragmatic in the sense, yeah, that's how he likes to play. I mean, yeah. That's the kind, yeah. And it's very much result oriented in that sense.
Yeah, like points. Yeah.
But at this point of time, I want to ask for like a coach like, or for any coach in the ISL, this is not like, I mean, I don't know, I'm asking you guys. Is this like the kind of competition where a coach's job is like severely under threat if they don't get the results?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, you think so?
I mean, particularly at clubs that have massive followings, And some of them do. I mean, now that ATK Mohan Bagan has inherited all of the fans that used to be only Mohan Bagan fans earlier. Kerala Blasters is another club that has, I mean, as our friends who join us in the chat tell us, the YouTube channels that are doing post-match and watch-alongs and other such in Malayalam have hundreds of thousands of people tuning in to watch and
maybe all. You're right, because Kerala have had some 700 coaches in the last 7 seasons.
Yeah, no, also this is like a global. I mean, it's how I think this.
True, I agree with the fact that it's what's global phenomenon.
हाँ तो भाई तो the way we are reacting also now like Pandit was pointing out the other day on the show. That you can see on the touchline anytime a referee makes a decision. And I'm not saying it. There have been some howlers. Some of the decisions have been absolutely like... I mean, I know that we have, as television viewers, the benefit of replays and all of that. But still, the guy on the referee on the pitch is supposed to be in the right position and gets to see it in real time. So, some of these things... I mean, like, for example, the yellow that Kone got today. Bakari Kone, the Kerala defender.
Yeah.
He clearly won the ball. I mean, you have tackled, won the ball, if where your foot is, if the other player who's also running onto the ball.
Falls on it.
So some of these decisions, of course, the penalty in the second game was spot on, I think.
Yeah.
A fair amount of pressure on the coaches, especially these coaches who come from abroad, because they're all foreign coaches, maybe not on particularly long-term deals and things like that. But for in relative to the Indian football context, highly paid coaches, probably getting paid at par or more than what they would be earning wherever they're from in Europe, whether it's Spain or elsewhere. So they need to win games to keep the fans happy and keep their jobs at the end of the day. I think there is pressure on them for sure.
And from the outside point of view of someone who has come to this show as like largely a non-football specialist kind of a reporter or whatever from cricket, I find that the ruthlessness football managers are changes terrifying. Either you should have been in football, you would have been out yesterday. You know, which I find it's in a way it's very sensible also in a way that your job is on the line every day kind of a thing. You know, this whole thing, if we are rebuilding and all, wo nahi chalta in football. You have to get points, you have to win the, you know, you have to at least do decently, not get relegated, all those things. So in a way, if it's happening in the ISL, it's good because it means that there is some sense of there are stakes in it that that are worth fighting for or worth being involved in. So in that way, if it means you will do parkbus, you will parkbus. You know, like
oh yeah, and like Jaideep has said many times on the show, when for ATK Mohan Bagan particularly, there is no such thing as second place from this season on. Case, and you know, with that, because of the stature or the size of the club and the following and all of these factors, I think a lot of coaches also want that job. They want to be in that position. We know for a fact that there are more coaches, more qualified coaches with like all kinds of international experience, right? Whether it's playing in the Premier League or having coached top teams around the world. So even there are far too few clubs to even employ all of these people with that knowledge and expertise. So the jobs are, there's tough competition for them. And it's a great book by, I think, Michael Calvin called Living on a Volcano, which is how he describes the predicament of the head coach in modern football. And what Shada was saying, how knee-jerk almost the reaction has become. Ki aap, sabse pehle aap coach ko nikalenge, uske baad, as though that will solve all your problems. I mean, unfortunately, it's an approach that doesn't, like you guys are saying, I mean, if you're thinking on from a long-term perspective, and if the management and the chairman and everybody kind of agrees that, okay, we have a five-year plan, then that's one way of looking at things. But very few, I think, also as fans
we don't have a five-year plans.
Like Sharda is saying, BFC mein ho kya raha hai? Do match hue hain. Or already.
And this is me. This is me behaving like a 14-year-old. You know, what is this? You know, yeah.
I guess but I mean, when you, one of the dangers of like, then you can't be sitting around and. This whole conversation about like playing young players, giving them opportunities, it becomes tough then for a coach if you put them in a situation where they have to get results. Then he's not going to.
But what is sport about? Sport is about results only, no?
I don't know. Like I mean, as
no, as, no. I mean, like so. You look at you. If you look at Kerala, for example, the results haven't been
coming for a while now.
Yeah. And this season ki baat karte hain chalo, and because they played the last game that we saw, so lucky to get away with a point from that game because the penalty should have been converted. It wasn't a great penalty. Still credit to the goalkeeper, of course, Gomez for the save, but not a particularly fantastic penalty to begin with. But so Kerala got lucky, got away with it a bit, but they're playing pretty decently. I mean, and I think when you have a, it depends on your fans also, how in tune they are with the club, how much into their football they are. So there could be clubs, I mean, there are definitely fans who ask or demand that a club play a certain way. So playing young players, someone like Rahul KP, who's from Kerala, local players coming in. I think Prashant is also a local player. So the kind of involvement then from everyone, that also, because at the end of the day, is league mein abhi to relegation wala factor nahi aaya hai na. So there's no worst case scenario from that point of view. So the pressure is to get results, also to play good football, entertaining football.
Yeah.
Because I think all of us fans, all of us who watch the game also realize that it is not a like world-class top league yet. It takes so we are fans because we watch, we like the sport, and we live in India, so we follow it, and so we're giving, or we want to. I mean, it'll take time to get wherever it has to get. So I think it's equally about the kind of football we're trying to play, and since even the national team coaches and things like that, they come into the conversation because these are the players that are feeding into the national team setup after all. So the kind of football that is played in the league structure, especially in the top league, is bound to also have an impact there with the national team. So, I think it's a tough one for coaches, for sure. How much to risk playing these young guys?
Like, for example, if you think about Kibu Vikuna, last season in the IN League, he just taken charge. I think his first game he drew and his second game he lost. And then after that, they didn't lose a single one.
Yeah.
Like, but I remember after those first two games, everyone was like, who's this guy? Where has he come from? Immediately.
Yeah.
He was trying to obviously like put in some process, something was happening.
Haan, but the, jab naya coach aayega, like, and especially, he likes to play a certain way.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, this is like exactly what I mean. Like, when you think about like guys like, say, Vikuna and Nobeda, these are two guys who immediately popping into my head compared to someone like Habas. Okay. And again, no, like I'm not like sitting around dissing Habas or like I'm not trying to turn this into like two camps. Okay. But obviously, like Habas will get results immediately because there is a certain way of playing there which is like result oriented. And yahan par wo result oriented game nahi hai, bro.
No, and maybe, also that he's built a team then with players in those key positions to do the job for him, right? You look at the kind of Indian players he's got, whether it's Pritham or Pranay and
Sandesh, man. Yeah.
Sandesh.
Yeah, Sandesh.
McHugh at the back. I think top quality second defender.
And that way, yeah, I do think like Kerala still.
And you have then Krishna in front to do that end of the
Shada, you were saying something. Maybe Abbas is the perfect fit for Mohan Bagan, whose fans will not else except domination. Yeah, I said maybe Abbas then is a for Mohan Bagan, because they're not going to have, there's no options only. There is no negotiating with Mohan Bagan fans about the kind of what they want at the end of the season. They want to win. So, and they don't care what, how, whatever, they want points. You know, so that way he's the perfect fit. Would somebody like Lobera be good in that thing? You don't know. Because you've got Mohan Bagan and you've now got Robbie Fowler. I want to see what happens if Robbie Fowler doesn't have, even though East Bengal were quite lovely that day, but if you don't get those results, then what happens, you know? Because everyone said, East Bengal's had such a bad run and now he has come, and there's every new coach is a new savior.
Oh, yeah, for someone, so, absolutely. For someone like Robbie Fowler, for example, at East Bengal, definitely it's a one-season sort of go at it. And that too, like, I don't think, because he comes with all the kind of reputation and all of that as a player that he does. So, I would find it extremely surprising unless something really disastrous happens. And we hope, of course, that we don't want to see any of that. But it's unlikely that it's any kind of long-term deal. I mean, they'll look at where they stand at the end of the season and then decide where to go from there.
Correct.
I mean, it's a tough scene for coaches.
I've just been looking at these comments, and like, there's one quick one that I just want to address. There's Nikhil Mishra who said, and this is just for Nikhil, we don't need to chat about this. Like, Nikhil has said AIFF may get banned if they don't hold elections in a month. So Nikhil, just for you, my friend, there's an exclusive story tomorrow morning on NewsClick. Okay, so stay tuned.
And we can post the link to that when it gets published here in the chat as well.
Full marks to Nikhil Mishra for bringing that up.
Really, yes. Like, and just for you, Nikhil, like, tomorrow morning, Monday blues ko mitayenge aap.
Subah. But, Anay, uspe hum baat karenge, vistar se baat karenge.
Yeah, exactly. We'll not talk about that now, just because.
Pehle story padhe sab log. Let's, we'll figure out what everything is going on, but. We'll talk at length, because elections are important and how these elections actually, what is the point of all of this, and who, like, just to talk about the decision making in football, how it happens a little bit, maybe. I think it's a fun chat. Always a little bit of politics always gets all of us a little excited. In Hindustani to hai hum. So,
exactly.
Anything else in the chat?
Also, actually, the IFA Shield. The IFA Shield story that Vaibhav had done, you know, the one about the fact that IFA ka shield ho raha hai. IFA is the oldest football body in the country, historically. And this bio bubble and all that thing, please, cheeky, don't get so serious. Maybe Vaibhav, you should just give your fans a little bit of a repeat of the story as you have written it. The superb story that you've done.
It's basically a micro version of what Bharat Sarkar is also doing with COVID, which is the apna dhyan khud rakhna. So wear a mask, everyone.
Hands off approach.
Yeah, it's a hands off approach to, I mean, play football if you want to play football.
Fair enough. I mean, yeah, it's a serious issue. I mean, because what will happen? Unfortunately, the people who are most hit will be those on the fringes. Like, all the effort is going into getting elite level sport back. But jo elite players already hain, wo already ban chuke hain elite, I think. So it would be, I think, useful to have a conversation about if elite sport is making a return, then how does that help different levels of the food chain, as it were. Because, like you're saying, it is free for all. I mean, we are also playing recreational games. It's basically it's based on how much you can trust that the other person is wearing their mask, not sort of going around meeting people and maintaining, I suppose, some kind of kya kehte hain, pandemic-induced decorum. But end of the day, I mean, you can't even say. And people have to work. People have to go out, do all those things. So it is happening on a complete free-for-all basis. And I don't think the IFA probably, they don't have the resources to organize the kind of bubble that is otherwise required, which they did for, let's say, the I-League second division. I think the costs of that are borne by the sponsors and the All India Football Federation, and IFA probably cannot afford to put, I mean, there's no way they can put however many teams, 10 teams in the tournament up at let's say the Hyatt where the I-League second division teams were staying. And I think which is also the three hotels that I have been selected for the I-League bubble, which will happen in Calcutta from January 9 onwards, I think are the Novotel, the Hyatt, and there's a third one. I think
they are all very close to the Salt Lake Stadium.
Yes,
like most probably, no, they're right in that same area.
Yeah, and maybe a Marriott or something like that. So you know, having 10 teams means ek team ka aap agar 20 kamre ke hisab se bhi laga lo, to 200 kamre. फाइव स्टार होटल या जो भी जितने भी स्टार का होटल हो फॉर द आईएफए टू पे दैट काइंड ऑफ मनी फॉर टीम एंड देन योर व्हाट एवरी फोर डेज टेस्टिंग फॉर ऑफ ईच ऑफ द प्लेयर्स
ट्वाइस अ वीक और समथिंग लाइक दैट सम मैड अमाउंट ऑफ
या सो एवरी थ्री फोर डेज बेसिकली दे आर टेस्टिंग ऑल द प्लेयर्स देयर इज मैसिव कॉस्ट इन्वॉल्वड इन ऑल ऑफ दिस व्हिच या अनफॉर्चूनेटली So down the road, I mean, like we were saying, the youth leagues are not happening this season also because of the pandemic.
Nobody is like even thinking about women's football or women's football or any women's sport.
Yeah. No. So to my mind, it's like this COVID pandemic is just perfect for sports administrators across the country. Kaam hi nahi karna hai. Kaam karna to bilkul top level wale ke saath kaam karna hai. So they'll get wah wah ki aray, you have done such great things. You have organized IPL. You have organized ISL. You have organized some high level event and bottom and out grassroots and all, please don't be serious. It cannot be done. Yeah. It's too complicated. It's COVID. And so this year and most probably the whole of next year also, it will just be. And if cricket is doing this, just imagine if cricket is doing this brazenly, we still don't have a schedule for first class cricket. Yeah. Never mind, say January. They keep saying, haan hoga, haan, we'll come to it, we'll decide and all. If cricket is doing this, so think about everybody else, you know.
It really is. And actually, like, what happens is, I mean, one only hopes that it won't, but it will eventually, like, this just taking this 1 year off and not doing any work at the grassroots is a huge hit for the whole system after a while. It's like, fir aap matlab bachpan mein bolte na chyawanprash khaoge to aapka immunity theek rahega, warna fir aap jaage ke dawaiyan khayenge fir baad mein.
Yeah,
so it's correct. Like that, and it's just that 1 year gap is going to hit you. Because see, like the Arrows, for example, they're going to play in the I League, and they're kids, right? Like they are team. So you got to take care of them. You got to make sure there is like a proper churn cycle. They're getting enough game time. There's enough time for them to graduate from the system, and just you don't want to jeopardize them in any way, even in terms of their health. So important.
In sport it is huge. 1 year in sport is huge. 1 year in particularly going from junior development level, it's crazy.
I mean, it was so casually that they've cancelled the women's under-17 World Cup, and one of the questions we were all asking was that will these girls be allowed to play in 2022? And they won't. Like as of now, no, they won't. No. So that means these girls.
On that front, I think, of course, for Because what happens is the cutoff date, right? The age, 2005 yeah. born, 2004 born. That's how critical it is, because they are literally one day on either side of that cutoff, and you can't play in a World Cup. So massive disappointment. But I think what will happen, at least because these are initial squads or initial years, as it were, for a national kind of training system for women at that under 17, under 16 level. Probably a bunch of them will transition to under 19, which is the best that can be hoped. Of course, they must be devastated to have like this opportunity and then like just disappear. I mean, I can't even imagine what that must feel like. That.
Yeah, I mean, also like just the callousness with which some of them were being treated, even when they were in contention for the under 17 World Cup team, the girls. Now imagine what will happen. Now they'll just be forgotten back. Okay, guys, like also like, again looking at the comments, like people have pointed out that this is a post-match show and we have not done anything. In fact, someone has
we have talked about the post-match, the match itself. It was a nil-nil draw. Actually, there wasn't.
We are bringing the goals. We are bringing the goals.
Yeah.
Someone has said that this show should be renamed Karl Marx Nationalism. I'm like totally on board.
Why? We have it's actually quite a catchy name, guys. 420 yeah. grams. It's pretty easy to remember. It's like alphanumeric. It ticks all the boxes. Like it's mildly funny. And
420 is like a great thing. You keep thinking 420 gram.
So, and ये हमारे अर्जुन पंडित की देन है उनका दिमाग चला क्या मतलब बत्ती जली आइडिया आया 420 ग्राम रखते हैं ना मतलब
पोस्ट मैच द थिंग इज फाइन एंड द दिस थिंग ऑफ नॉट डिस्कसिंग समथिंग लाइक दिस एंड सेइंग कार्ल मार्क्स एंड नेशनलिज्म एंड ऑल दैट यू थिंकिंग भाई दिस इज व्हाट योर स्पोर्ट इज मेड ऑफ व्हेन यू आर सेइंग व्हाई डज इट प्ले द वर्ल्ड कप These are the things that you have to constantly be aware of while you enjoy the match, while you enjoy the goals, while you want to see Chahal and apna Anirudh Thapa and Rahul KP do well, but you also have to know that this is happening. So it's
this is where they came from, also, by the way. From exactly. the grassroots. And unfortunately, none of us knew them when they were at the grassroots, which we don't want to happen, right? Like, we want to know, we want to make sure there's going to be like at least like 50 yeah. of these kids coming up every year.
Yes.
Absolutely. So, but since it has been brought up and since you brought it up very aptly, Vaibhav, anything more to add on any of the games? Nishu Kumar is another guy, I think, who's just cementing his place as actually maybe interesting competition for that right back spot for as far as India is concerned.
Yes.
Coming up, because that's something that we definitely like to keep an eye out on.
Nishu is 22?
Sorry?
Also from BFC.
Also from BFC.
He's from UP. He's not from BFC.
Hello. He has played for BFC. Huh? He has played for BFC many successful seasons he has played.
Yes. He's actually, like, it cannot deny. Like, this is also,
cannot deny.
This is, I mean, I don't know if you guys who are watching also can tell us, like, how many players you know from UP who have come out in recent times.
That's like this. I would, Manveer Singh is from where? Jisne wo...
Manveer?
Mohan Bagan ka goal score kiya hai. Super goal.
Yeah. Oh, I have a very interesting story about Manveer also.
Tell.
I just tell you guys, but I won't just write about it.
Oh, you have to write. Okay.
Okay. Hold the thought then. You write about it and then we'll talk about it after that.
Yes. After you look on the story.
Any more comments? Guys, I know you're all very disappointed that Arjun Pandit is not with us. I think...
Guys, you should be disappointed. Star. He gave up you guys to go and do cricket. और आप लोग उसके पीछे पड़े हुए हैं अगर मैं होता तो मैं आउटरेज्ड होता आई वुड हैव बीन लाइक कि तुम यार अर्जुन आपने धोखा दे दिया हमें
What are they saying about where is Arjun? Where is Arjun? What are the comments? Because I can see
it. No, they're just missing him. They want him here, as do we. But you know, you can't always get what you want and all that.
Devjit Saha, I'm reading the comments from. I have this like supernatural ability to see a comment, so I can see you, my friend. You're asking this question. I can see you.
So lots of regulars on the chat. Shout out to all of you guys as well as some new names I can
How
see.
How many people?
We have, I think, close to 75 watching right now.
Oh, I'm telling you, Arjun Pandit is the man who brings in hundreds.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's why cricket took him. Oh. They can't generate their own stars.
No real questions, just lots of comments. Hooper is one that we could talk about. Much talked about Aussie striker. I think he had the stats indicated he had 8 goals in the A-League last season.
Yes.
Plus a bunch of assists, and he's come in as pretty much a first choice.
I don't think he's Aussie. I think he's English.
No,
right?
English. But English. What I'm saying, what I meant is he comes from the Aussie League. Yeah, he's English. What do you guys make of him? He didn't have a great debut and didn't get his name on the sheet today as well. But still seems the coach has some faith in him, some confidence in him, and wants to give him a run.
I mean, with these foreign players, you would want them, particularly the ones that are like the star players, you would want them to be visible and immediately be seen and understand what that quality is, which you can tell with a lot of, even there's this the Tajikistan guy who came on as a replacement. You see them immediately. The substitute who came on the first match and scored 2 goals, Maurizio. From the Brazilian guy who came on and he scored the equalizers for Odisha. So in that sense, you see, and it's not that, okay, you only have to score goals, but you have to see their presence even in as defenders or as midfielders or as playmakers like Kriviano. But that you don't see that yet in Hooper. At least I didn't. I don't know.
Yeah, no, it's not there. Like also you can see them off the pitch also. Like in the first game, for example, like Marcelinho. Once he got taken off, you could see he was like standing in the dugout, like constantly screaming, getting guys in position, just doing that sort of stuff. And then same for Jamshedpur Valskis. Is that how you pronounce his name? Oh man, he's such a phenomenal player. Oh wow, I really like him. Like one of those few really under the radar type guys, foreign players that you don't really like. I mean, sorry to talk about foreign players at such length, but yeah, he is like truly. He does have some sort of impact on games. So I think there's a lot to learn from these boys, just in terms of like just the way they like push guys into position, just doing stuff like that. So with Hooper, not yet. Haven't seen this yet.
Yeah,
although he does remind me a little bit. In BFC's first season, they had this Australian player.
They have one now, that famous one, Partalu.
No, in their first season ever, not in their first season in the ISL. Sinan, you'd probably remember him.
Australian player in the first season?
Yeah. He was a...
Number
10.
I'm forgetting.
I'm eating, I don't mind.
Maybe the chat crew can help us. I think Eric joined after they had moved to the ISL already. Right?
ISL,
Rooney.
Yeah.
I think is the
Rooney. Yeah? Yes.
Rooney.
Yes. That was him. Oh, he was a good... I mean, I liked him.
So why are you making the comparison with Rooney?
I don't know. There's like a certain...
Presence.
Like in just the understated... Abhi tak understated, I'm hoping. I hope it's not ineffective. मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि there's like also physically they're like sort of similar, so maybe there'll be something.
And the other thing that is very obvious to see is just the physicality of all the players from abroad that are there, and how unique to have Indians that can match it. You know, or at least be able to stand ground. Who maybe a lot of them are smaller, physically smaller, but they need to be. You need like jingan level to be there. You know, you need that kind of like substantial. Jisko bolte hain. And you see all the defenders are these big, huge guys, and you're thinking that okay, now you either you're whoever's trying to get past them, if you're a striker or if you're slightly in the forward line or in midfield, you have to be really fast, because if they come and stamp on you, then that's it. You're just knocked over. You know. That's what you do see. Even aaj kaun tha those two in Kerala, is it Kerala that has got those two?
Kerala has two foreigners playing as center back, Kone and Costa.
But both made a lot of errors today. Huh? Like the penalty was totally a defensive mistake at the halfway line. Like it was totally.
But today Kone saved them when that Albino Gomez came off the line. Kone is a guy who cleared the ball.
He almost made up for it with that huge error that gave Chennai the chance for that counter. It's a terrible error near the halfway. Like a defender pushing up that hard.
Actually, it was Sido's final challenge that got the.
That was true. That's true.
That was also pretty disastrous.
Very bad.
It looked like one of those really clumsy, heavy challenges that absolutely non-controversial penalty calls. Fair enough. I think so. We've done quite.
And I'm thinking that.
Go on, Chada. Sorry.
I said we've done quite exhaustive discussion today. Of all kinds of issues.
Yes.
Exhaustive is perhaps what we think. There may be others who will use other exhaust plus.
क्या बात है यार ये ना spelling वाले jokes सही है अभी grammar jokes best kind of humor is very at the very top of the humor level. Elite level.
I'm bringing my English teacher jokes to the table.
Elite level.
Well played. I was gonna say exactly the same thing before exhaustive turns to exhausting. Let's can it. Let's say goodnight to each other and to all of our friends who are watching this show. Thank you guys once again for tuning in. I hope you have, as always, liked or disliked, whichever the case might be. We appreciate both as long as you're participating in this friendly discourse discussion. Sorry, we haven't taken too many of your comments. I think the actual fan favorite, jo hai na, jo jinse aap yahan baat karne aate hain, wo aaj hai nahi hamare saath. To aap sab dobara aayega kal parson jab bhi hum batayenge aapko next kya scene hai, because kitna josh rahega humme jari ki har match dekhein, uske baad uske bare mein baat karein. But hopefully kayam rakhenge isko. We'll have a schedule out for the week. We'll cover a few matches, particularly on Sunday. We will definitely be back, looking at how the week has panned out as well as the weekend's action. Sharda, thanks so much for bringing in your Bangalore FC perspective. we'll talk later in the season about how that's going, but I think definitely maybe we should pick a Bangalore game to look at next, and bring those guys into the competition, into the conversation.
Into the competition also.
Yeah. maybe. Who knows? fair enough. Vaibhav, fun chatting with you as always. Please keep working on the jokes, man. You're bringing the quality. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone who's tuned in. Thanks. Subhashish Bose. Devji, I've mentioned Subhashish Bose. Sorry. I just saw your comment right now. I really like him. Pandit doesn't. So we'll have a very engaged discussion on Subhashish in the next episode for sure. I will remember that. Thank you guys for watching. This is 420 Grams. We'll see you on the next show. Thank you.